Edie, where were you born?
I was born in Košice, Czechoslovakia, K-O-S-I-C-E.
K-O-S-I-C-E. Mm-hmm. Did you ever have any other names that you went by besides Elephant?
No, that was my only name, and Eger is my married name.
Okay. I hate to ask you this, but what is your birth date?
My birthday is September 29th, 1927. I like my age.
Okay.
I just had my 68th birthday.
Edie, tell me about your family. What was your father's name?
My father's name was Lajos in Hungarian, Ludwig, and he was a very creative man who worked himself up from being a tailor to being a designer, and I was very, very lovingly watching my dad evolving so beautifully. He was a ladies' man.
Tell me, just to backtrack for a moment, how do you spell his name?
His name, L-A-J-O-S.
And his middle name?
Middle name, I don't...
I
don't think he had a middle name.
Okay. And your mother, what was her name?
Her name was Ilona, I-L-O-N-A, Klein, K-L-E-I-N.
Do you know her birth date?
Her birthday was March 25th, 1898.
And
my dad's March 29th, 1892.
Where was your father born?
He was born in Czechoslovakia, a place called Trebišov. T-R-E-B-I-S-O-V.
And your mother?
And my mother was born in Košice, I believe. I really am not so sure now that you're asking. I think she was born in Košice as well.
Now, there were some other children in your family.
Yes, I have two sisters, beautiful sisters, Magdalena, as she likes to call herself, and she lives in Baltimore, Maryland, and Clara, K-L-A-R-A, who lives in Sydney, Australia, and she's coming to visit me in a couple of weeks.
How wonderful.
Yeah.
Let's go back to Magdalena,
mm-hmm.
Is it? How do you spell her name?
M-A-G-D-A-L-E-N-A.
Now, which one of the sisters are the eldest?
Magdalena is the oldest, but don't tell her.
Okay.
Yeah.
And then after
then
Magdalena?
Then Clara, and then me.
So you're the youngest in your family.
I'm the youngest.
Okay. Tell me some of the early things that you remember about your family life in Košice.
Well, my recollection is that I remember my parents had two girls and they wanted a son, and here I am. I kind of always felt that my parents wanted me to be a boy and I wasn't. And what I remember early on, that I was very ill when I was 3 years old. I almost died of a Spanish fever, some epidemic was going on. And the doctor put a needle in one ear and then somehow touched my eyes, and I became a cross-eyed little girl. I was teased a lot. Hmm. I felt I was the ugliest little girl around, to the point that I walked on the streets and I was looking at the pavement because I didn't want you to be in shock of my ugly face. And so I don't have very, very good memories as a child, but the wonderful memory I have was that my mother was a very wise, beautiful woman who took me to a ballet school when I was very young, and I began to speak with my body. I had a very spiritual, wonderful ballet master who said to me that God built me in such a magnificent way that whatever happens to me, I always have to find the power from within. And I remember in Auschwitz, I was thinking of him, that now it's the time for me to find from within what never came from without.